I'm Josie Fischels with Iowa Public Radio, here with the members of the last dinner party at Hinterland 2024.
Hey, everybody.
Hi.
Hello. So I wanted to warm us up. Just let's start with introductions. I'll go down the line here. Could you each say your name and what you play or your role?
Hi, I'm Emily and I play lead guitar.
Hi, I'm Lizzie. I sing and play guitar.
I'm Abigail. I sing.
I'm Georgia. I play bass.
Hi, I play keyboards and I sing, and I'm Aurora.
Wonderful. It's been a huge year for your debut album, Prelude to Ecstasy. Most recently, it was shortlisted for the Mercury Prize. How does it feel?
It feels amazing to be recognized by such a prestigious award that's kind of more, I don't know, Yeah, it's just really prestigious in the UK, and we feel really honoured to be nominated. Yeah.
yeah. No, it's great.
What Emily said.
I think we all have the same. Yeah. I mean, I think it's really lovely to be recognised alongside so many people that we respect and adore so much, like with our peers, and it's kind of cool to be nominated and feel like, oh, like we're in this really exciting scene in the UK, and to be recognised. Even just nominated is like enough to be like really happy about.
You're absolutely right. You were nominated against some pretty big names, especially this summer, including Charlie XCX's Brat, which is very impressive and wonderful. It seems like everyone here in the States has heard Nothing Matters on TikTok. What is it like as artists to experience TikTok virality?
It's really interesting because it's not something that we've ever kind of focused on. I think the way that we've built a fan base in the UK has been through our live performances and through, yeah, no, exactly through our live performances, basically. So I think having some TikTok notoriety is kind of a byproduct of what we have done, but we've never actually kind of tried to foster that. So it's kind of an interesting sensation to be like, oh, you're known on TikTok, where we've never made a TikTok in our lives.
Most of us don't have the app.
Is that true? You don't have the app?
I don't, no.
Wow. Do you now?
No.
Okay. They do not have the app. That is interesting. So, I mean, given that, like, how are you even like seeing like this moment and like taking advantage of it when it really hit viralness?
I think it's by the amount of people who then come to the live shows, because you know that there's obviously more and more people every time having heard the song, however they have, whether it's on the radio or on social media or whatever. And every time we come back to the States or play a different festival, there's more and more people in the crowd. So that's kind of the only way that we can gauge the success that we have. Yeah,
I think we're also really lucky because none of us are really very social media savvy or wanted to, so we have Nora, who is here with us, who does all our TikToks and our social media and is a lot better at it than we would be if we tried to do it on our own. So I think we're lucky to be in that situation where she can kind of help us navigate it, because I think you do kind of have to use it in this day and age, and because we struggle with doing trends and wanting to, you know, be involved in it, it's good to have help.
Excellent. Yeah, because I was wondering how you kind of seize on to that moment. It's an exciting thing to have a song get so much traction, and then like where do you go from there? What are the challenges, I guess?
I guess because we're not on TikTok, we don't really fall into the loop of wah, like the spiral of worrying about being on TikTok again or going viral again. I think we just focus on the art and doing what we do. Like that's what we've done all our lives, and that's what we kind of feel a need to do, like passionate towards. So just focusing on that, on making and creating, collaborating, that's kind of our mindset, I think.
I like that answer. I also love the story of how you all kind of came together. There was a few of you who met during, I guess it's called Freshers Week.
Yeah. Do you call it like Rush? What do you
call it? I guess it's Rush for sororities. I don't even orient. I don't even know, like orientation. Yeah. Well, yeah. If you wouldn't mind telling me the story.
So Georgia and I met
about like a week before uni started, and we were on the same course, and we were introduced by a mutual friend. We met at a pub, obviously. And then you two met in halls.
We were living in the same like crappy building. We met on the very first night that we moved in, and we were just in the corner, like not particularly socially capable. So gravitated together. And then when we made the band and wanted to be in a band, we realized we needed some more musicians, and we asked around, and two mutual friends were connected with Emily and Aurora, so we folded them in. Mm-hmm. And then yeah, that's it.
I understand at the beginning you kind of had some difficulty getting together to rehearse. How did you overcome that challenge?
Yeah, it was really frustrating because it was the pandemic, and we do like two rehearsals, and then it'd be like lockdown, oh, we can't see each other. So yeah, it was a lot of Zoom calls. Me and Georgia lived together, so it was a lot of just getting drunk every day and waiting. Waiting and waiting and waiting. And then every time they lifted it a bit, we'd, you know, get straight in the rehearsal studio. But yeah, no, it was hard to keep the momentum going. There was definitely some like kind of moments of like, oh my god, is this ever gonna happen? But yeah, I think it worked out pretty well because we got to have this gestation period, and then we could come out to our first gig like ready to go and really well rehearsed. So yeah, it's good.
Absolutely wonderful. I look at this band and I think of artwork. Between your style and even the themes explored in your album, you're like a painting in a museum or a cathedral come to life. Thanks, I came up with that on my own. I just wanted to ask what the inspiration behind that was. Or inspirations, I suppose.
I mean, yeah, it is plural. I think it's, I've said this before, but I feel like it's a product of kind of being a band brought up in the internet age and kind of being able to access so much, like from history, from films, from other artists, from designers, you know, different eras. And I think growing up with that kind of approach to seeing everything all at once and it kind of all being absorbed, I think it makes sense that we kind of came out like this with a kind of magpied, tapestried look, kind of maximalist approach to putting things together and not really having one single thing that inspires us, but just more of a kind of exciting and an eclectic approach to kind of finding different things.
I like that idea of like the internet age, especially as a Gen Z band. Specifically, what about the internet? Like, I'm a Pinterest girl, I'm a YouTube girl, I'm a TikTok girl.
Exactly. Yeah, Pinterest, definitely Tumblr. Mm-hmm. I think the way that you're delivered information on websites like Pinterest and Tumblr is just like so kind of unorganized, mm-hmm. unless you're searching specific kind of hashtags or whatever. But if you're just on your main feed, it's just everything. It's everything that you've ever been interested or shown interested in or whatever. So yeah, it's kind of like a disorganized, but also it's coherent because it's you and it's what you like. So I think it's things like Tumblr and Pinterest delivering you, you know, a still from a horror movie next to a beautiful dress next to a photo of Prince or something, you know. Yeah. Like just random, and then yeah, and then you throw all that together and that's us, and we have all of those different influences as a group, but also as individual people with different upbringings and backgrounds and all of that. So yeah, it's all just all of it.
Excellent. Wonderful. I love that. All right. And between, do you think you'll maintain this kind of aesthetic that you've built already throughout?
We're literally just talking about this. I think one of the most important things for us is we don't feel like we have to do the same thing over and over again, because we've never done things because of trends or because we think it will be popular or we think people will like it. We do it because we like it, and I feel like we're kind of letting our style naturally evolve as people, you know, as the next album starts to come around, the next cycle will grow and change and just kind of, I think the main thing is that we want to always have is just the sincerity and an earnest approach to what we want to wear and what we want to do. And I think we'd be quite bored if we had to wear just ball gowns forever or, you know, just one thing. So I think we're kind of gently allowing the styles to grow and evolve as we do with the music.
Well, for now I'm digging the ball gowns. And wonderful. All right. You've mentioned before that you don't think that being a non-male band should be considered groundbreaking, and so I was wondering what you prefer audience and media to think of you as instead.
Wow. band.
Full stop. Yeah, we're just a band. We play instruments just like other people in bands do, and
I think we want to get to a point, like the dream is as a society to get to the point where a group of women and queer people or whatever in a band is not seen as kind of anything different or revolutionary. And like when you look at a group of men in a band, they're never referred to as a male band. They are just a band.
It's a default.
So we want there to be no default of gender balance or anything. It's just, we are a band. They are a band. Mm-hmm. That's it. Yeah.
100%. Great. All right. And I should have asked this at the beginning, but I was just fairly curious. When you first started out, you were just the dinner party. Is this correct? Where did last come from?
It was actually, there was a jazz supergroup called Dinner Party, and they were really, really successful. And so we had to change it. But they were so nice about it. They had a nice little interaction on emails. Yeah, and added last, and I like it better now. Yeah, I think it's an improvement, to be honest.
Also love the band Dinner Party.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
They're a great band. Yeah. Just want to...
Yeah. Yeah. Only love.
So did last just kind of come organically? Were you searching on the internet? Like, oh no, we have to figure this out.
It was because we wanted to keep the name and the kind of the ethos, because that's where the band kind of emerged from, the idea of like the dinner party. But I think the word last is so evocative and so cinematic, like what would happen at the very last dinner party on earth, you know? And like, you know, it has kind of Last Supper. It's kind of like a funny play on the Last Supper. So yeah, I think it's the only word that really fit in that we could change the name enough for it to be distinct from the dinner party.
We really brainstormed.
I really searched the annals of my mind.
Yeah, that was scary.
Scary week.
I think it came as such a surprise to me to learn that it wasn't the original, because I absolutely was thinking of the Last Supper, and I think a lot of people do, and especially with the themes of Catholicism that can come up in your music, it really makes sense. Yeah. So that's really neat to learn. Absolutely. Okay, wonderful. So you've opened for Hozier in the past, and he's here today. Have you interacted since opening for him at the beginning of the tour?
No, I haven't seen him yet. Okay. So maybe we'll run into him.
Yeah, I've said hi to some people.
Yeah, it's nice to like be to do festivals now, like the more we go on as a band, because we start to like have friends everywhere we go, and that's a really nice feeling. So maybe we'll see him. I hope so. We'll stick around. Find Andy.
Watch the show.
Yeah.
Excited to perform.
Yeah. Yes. I'm nervous about the heat.
Yeah. Sure.
We've had to have some outfit changes.
I wasn't gonna ask this on the air, but actually, I'm wearing makeup, and I don't know what setting spray I'm supposed to be using out here right now, because it is melting already. So if you have recommendations, I'm very eager.
I use Urban Decay All Nighter. That's what I use.
I just can't wear foundation because it'll just slide right off.
Waterproof mascara.
Yeah. We're far away on stage, like no one can see up close.
Might be a no makeup day.
Last dinner party, thank you so much.
Thank you.